टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द लेसर सैक. लेसर सैक इट इज अ रिसेस ऑफ पेरिटोनियल कैविटी दैट हिडन बिहाइंड टू द हियर. यू कैन सी दिस इज द अम्बिलिकस, दिस इज द फाल्सिफॉर्म लिगामेंट एंड मोस्ट लोअर पार्ट ऑफ द फाल्सिफॉर्म लिगामेंट. इट इज द लिगामेंटम टेरिस. इट इज द ऑब्लिटरेटेड लेफ्ट अम्बिलिकल वेन. सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द लेसर सैक. इट इज द रिसेस ऑफ पेरिटोनियल कैविटी हिडन बिहाइंड टू द लेसर ओमेंटम. दिस इज द लेसर ओमेंटम बिहाइंड टू द स्टमक एंड एंटीरियर टू लेयर ऑफ द ग्रेटर ओमेंटम. सो लेसर सैक इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड द ओमेंटल बर्सा. इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड द ओमेंटल बर्सा एंड मेनली इट इज द पोटेंशियल स्पेस बिहाइंड टू द लेसर ओमेंटम स्टमक एंड एंटीरियर टू लेयर ऑफ द ग्रेटर ओमेंटम एंड द superiorly behind to the caudate process of the caudate lobe of the liver. So this is the, I will insert the my forceps through the epiploic foramen inside the lesser sac. You can see this is the lesser sac, and here you can see these are the anterior layer of the, this is the lesser omentum from the ligamentum fissures venosus to the लेसर कर्वेचर ऑफ द स्टमक एंड एंटीरियर फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द डिओडिनम और फर्स्ट 2 सेंटीमीटर ऑफ द डिओडिनम. सो इट इज द पोटेंशियल स्पेस एंड और रिसेस विच गिव्स द स्पेस फॉर द एक्सपांसन ऑफ द स्टमक दैट वाई इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड द ओमेंटल बर्सा एंड थ्रू द एपिप्लोइक फोरामेन विच इज कम्युनिकेटेड विद द ग्रेटर सैक. It is communicated with the greater sac by the epiploic foramen. So, it has a two boundaries, anterior boundaries, and the behind to the lesser sac. It is a posterior boundary of the lesser sac. It has a 4 margin, lower margin. It has a right margin. It has a left margin. It has a upper margin of the lesser sac. So the lesser sac, which is again divided by the epiploic foramen, here you can see, first of all I will discuss about the epiploic foramen. It is the right free margin of the lesser omentum. It is called the right free margin of the lesser omentum. It is called the porta hepatis, and this epiploic foramen, it is the gap behind to the porta hepatis, which communicate the lesser sac through the greater sac. It is anteriorly bounded by the porta hepatis, portal vein, hepatic artery, and bile duct, which is lies inside the porta hepatis. Posteriorly, it is bounded by the, here you can see this, posteriorly it is bounded by the inferior vena cava, and below it is bounded by the first part of the duodenum, and above it is bounded by the caudate process of the liver. And the caudate process of the liver, it is the right extension of the, it is the right extension, right, this is the right lobe of the liver, this is the left lobe of the liver. It is the right extension of the right lobe of the liver towards the left side. It is the caudate process, and this is the caudate lobe of the liver between the inferior vena cava and the portal vein. Inferior vena cava and portal vein, this is called the caudate process of the liver, and this is a caudate lobe of the liver. So the superiorly, we already discussed the epiploic foramen, which is bounded by the caudate process. Inferiorly, first part of the duodenum, posteriorly it is bounded by the inferior vena cava, and anteriorly it is bounded by the porta hepatis. This level of the epiploic foramen, behind to the lesser omentum, this level of the lesser sac, it is called the vestibules. Above to this vestibule, it is called the superior recess of the lesser sac. Behind to the lesser omentum and stomach, the part of the lesser sac, it is called the body of the lesser sac. Behind to the lesser omentum and stomach, it is called the body of the lesser sac. Below to the stomach, part between the four layer of the greater omentum between the second and third layer of the, mainly the second and third layer of the greater omentum, it is called the inferior recess of the lesser omentum, and the part of the lesser sac which extend towards the left side between the stomach and spleen on the posterior aspect, it is called the splenic recess. So these are the part of the lesser sac, mainly on the left extension of the lesser sac, it is called the splenic recess between the fundus of the stomach and spleen on the, from the right side, it is the splenic recess. Behind to the chordate process, the superiorly, it is called the superior recess. Behind to the lesser omentum and the body of the stomach, it is called the behind to the lesser omentum and stomach, it is called the body of the lesser sac. And below to the, between the four, here you can see this is the anterior two layer. This is the first layer of the greater omentum, and this is the second layer of the greater omentum. In between, there is a, my finger, it is stomach, and then it covers, goes downwards, and the space between the second layer and third layer, which is formed automatically when it fold posteriorly, the second layer become third layer and first layer become fourth layer. So the space between second and third layer of the greater omentum, it is called the inferior recess of the lesser sac. But normally this sac, lesser inferior recess, which is due to the zygosis, it is fused. So basically there are two surface, anterior surface, it has a posterior surface, lesser sac have a posterior surface, upper border, left border, lower border, and right border. Now we will discuss about the anterior boundary of the lesser sac, which is formed by the peritoneum covering to the caudate lobe on the upper aspect. It is difficult to show here. The posterior layer of the lesser omentum, and then it is the peritoneum covering to the posterior surface of the stomach. Here this is the posterior and inferior aspect of the stomach, and then it is the peritoneum covering posterior part of the stomach and first part of the duodenum, and the second layer of the greater omentum, which makes the, here I will put this two layer. Here you can see this is the anterior layer of the greater omentum, this is a second layer. So this makes the anterior boundary of the lesser sac, this makes the posterior boundary, third layer makes the posterior boundary of the lesser sac. So anterior boundary, which is formed by the peritoneum covering to the caudate lobe, posterior layer of the lesser omentum, inferior to the stomach, the posterior layer of the lesser omentum, which is continuous as a peritoneum covering to the posterior surface of the stomach, first part of the duodenum, and the second layer of the greater omentum. It is the anterior boundary. The posterior boundary of the lesser sac, which is formed by the peritoneum covering the third layer of the greater omentum, or either you can also explain as a posterior two layer of the greater omentum, but mainly it is related with the third layer, because it is fold anterior two layer, which is fold posteriorly. So third layer of the greater omentum, fourth layer also lies posteriorly, but third layer, it is related with the lesser sac. So third layer of the greater omentum and the peritoneum, after that peritoneum covering to the structure forming the stomach bed, which is goes on the posterior aspect here. These are the from the transverse colon. Here you can see this is the transverse colon, transverse mesocolon, and pancreas. Here at that level, level of the transverse colon on the posterior aspect, there is a pancreas. This level, there is a pancreas. So peritoneum covering to the pancreas, upper part of the left kidney on the inner side. It is difficult to show you inner side. It is a there is a upper part of the left kidney and left suprarenal gland, and ultimately this peritoneum, which is reflected over the diaphragm. So the posterior boundary of the lesser sac, which is mainly formed by the third layer of the greater omentum, then the this third layer of the greater omentum, and then peritoneum, which is goes superiorly, and the structure forming the stomach bed, mainly the peritoneum covering to the transverse colon and transverse mesocolon. It covers to the anterior surface of the pancreas. Then it covers to the left side of the kidney and left suprarenal gland, and then it reflected to the diaphragm. So this is the posterior boundary. The lower margin, it is the lesser sac, which is formed by the anterior two layer, which is reflected as a posterior two layer. It is the lower margin. This is the lower margin of the lesser sac. Upper margin of the lesser sac, which is here, you can see it is difficult to show over the body. I will keep the into the body. It is difficult to the upper reflection of the over the caudate lobes. The peritoneum reflect from the diaphragm to the caudate lobe of the liver on the right side, and on the left side, which is there is a reflected over the stomach, on the posterior side of the stomach, and it makes the gastrocnemic ligament, and it is reflected over the from the stomach to the diaphragm, and it makes the gastrocnemic ligament. So superiorly the peritoneum reflected from the diaphragm to the caudate lobe of the liver. In small, you have to remember. So it is the upper margin of the lesser sac. The left margin of the lesser sac, which is formed by the on the lower part by the blind part of the greater omentum below to the infracolic part, it is a left margin of the greater omentum. Then internally, the lesser sac, which is extend internally, the lesser sac, which is extend over the peritoneum from the greater omentum through the transverse mesocolon, and it continuously it makes the lateral extension of the lesser sac, mainly the right layer of the leno-renal ligament and gastrocnemic ligament, which is the upper boundary. Here you can see this is the kidney and this is the spleen. On here I will just you can see this my forceps, which is come inside the lesser sac. It is come out through the I will just tear the leno-renal ligament between this is a left kidney and this is a spleen, and it tear it as a two layer mainly on the this side it is the left side, and from the towards the lesser sac it is the right layer. So it is a right layer of the leno-renal ligament and right layer of the gastrosplenic ligament. It is a splenic extension, splenic recess of the lesser sac. It is the completion of the left margin. And the right margin, you have to remember the lesser sac, it is a hot water bag like, and it is opening towards the right side by the epiploic foramen. So the right border of the lesser sac, which is incomplete because the bottle which is open towards the right side, it is the irregular bottle like. So the right border, which is formed by the into the lower part by the right margin of the lesser omentum, right margin of the lesser omentum. So what happened? This is the right margin of the lesser sac or greater omentum. So right margin of the lesser sac, which is formed by the lower by the right margin of the greater omentum from the up to the transverse colon, up to the transverse colon, and between the transverse colon and first part of the duodenum, this is the here you can see this is the transverse colon and up to the first part of the duodenum. This is the transverse colon and first part of the duodenum. The layer of the peritoneum from the right margin, first part between the transverse colon and first part of the duodenum, right margin, which is formed by the reflection of the peritoneum. Reflection of the peritoneum from the neck of the pancreas. But we have not dissected here the neck of the pancreas. So from the neck of pancreas to the posterior surface of the first part of the duodenum, this fold of the peritoneum, it is called the reflection of the right margin of the lesser sac from the transverse colon to the first part of the duodenum, and it goes to the posterior surface of the first part of the duodenum. And then from the duodenum to the liver, there is a deficit, right margin, which is deficit, which is formed by the epiploic foramen. And previously we already discussed the boundary of the epiploic foramen. And on the upper aspect, which is formed by the above to the epiploic foramen, the right margin, which is formed by the peritoneal reflection of the from the diaphragm to the right pre-margin of the caudate lobe, right pre-margins of the caudate lobe. So here it is the upper margin, and it is the reflected from the caudate lobe to the diaphragm. So this is the right pre-margin, which is reflected to the caudate lobe, and it is reflected over the diaphragm. So this is and it is the left edge of the inferior vena cava, and right side of the caudate lobe. In between there is a reflection to the diaphragm. It is above to the epiploic foramen, and this is the level of the epiploic foramen. And so epiploic foramen, anteriorly above it is bounded by the caudate lobe, posteriorly by the inferior vena cava, anteriorly by the porta epitis, and below by the first part of the duodenum. So this is the right margin, which is formed by the right margin of the greater omentum, and from the greater right margin of the greater omentum, and then the transverse colon to the first part of the duodenum, the peritoneum reflected from the neck of the pancreas to the posterior border of the first part of the duodenum, and from the duodenum to the liver, it is deficit, it is formed by the epiploic foramen, and from the above to the epiploic foramen, the peritoneum, which is reflected from the right edge of the caudate lobe and above to the diaphragm. So this is the right margin of the lesser sac. You have to remember it has a four margin: inferior margin, superior margin, left margin, right margin of the lesser sac. It has a two surface: anterior surface and posterior surface. It has a three recess. Greater omentum, part of the potential space inside the greater omentum, it is called the inferior recess. Space between the behind to the greater lesser omentum and stomach, it is called the body of the lesser sac. And the recess which is extension towards the spleen side, it is called the splenic recess. So three recess: inferior recess, splenic recess, and the part behind to the caudate lobe of the lesser sac, it is called the superior recess. Part behind to the caudate lobe, it is called the superior recess. So inferior recess, splenic recess on the left side, it is the left extension of the lesser sac, and superior recess behind to the caudate process, and body of the lesser sac, it is called the behind to the lesser omentum, and the stomach, it is called the body of the lesser sac. Internally, at the level of the epiploic foramen, the lesser sac, it is called the vestibules, and there are two fold which is formed. One fold which is goes downwards and forwards and towards the right side, it is fold by the left gastric artery, and the fold which is created by the hepatic artery, it is the gastropancreatic fold. It is the fold which is goes towards the left side, and upside it is fold by the hepatic artery inside the porta hepatis. So these are the two fold where there is a narrow inner side of the lesser sac, and it divides the lesser sac into the upper part and lower part of the lesser sac. So sometimes main function of the lesser sac to allow the expansion of the stomach after taking the food. But sometimes there is a gastric ulcer which lead to rupture of the gastric ulcer or perforations of the gastric ulcer. It lead to there is a liquid which is goes inside the lesser sac, and lesser sac which is communicated with the greater sac, mainly the hepatorenal pouch, by the epiploic foramen. So you have to remember there are two surfaces of the lesser sac: anterior surface, posterior surface. It has a four margin: lower margin, upper margin, right margin, and left margin. And you have to remember all the boundary. You have to remember all three recesses: inferior recess, splenic recess, and superior recess behind to the caudate lobe, and vestibules of the lesser sac. Hope you will understand the lesser sac. It is the most difficult topics inside the abdomen.